Growing companies always need to be thinking about the future and building what's next, and that can be a really messy process. So we want to walk through an example here at SafetyCulture that we are currently going through.
I was hired to help start a team that brought or thought about how IoT technology could have an impact on customers who are using iAuditor as a software application.
The idea was that we have customers doing millions of checks every single month, but a big number of those checks are very routine, they're manual, they're laborious, and they're perfect candidates for automation.
The team was the leanest team you could possibly imagine. It was literally two people. One of us came from a consulting background, the other one came from a tech background. There was a huge scope and an unknown problem that we were brought on to solve. It was an incredible amount of freedom, but at the same time, it was really challenging for us to actually try and scope it down to a discrete problem set.
We didn't want to be another company that just took a really cool, sexy piece of technology and forced it on our customers. From day one, we had to be pulled by the customer. And if that direction took us in using a new technology, such as sensors or Internet of Things, great, but that wasn't our mandate. Once we had the idea of sort of what sensors had to be, we knew we wanted to have it as a self-service product. They had to have this software and this hardware on their own site and be able to set it up without anyone sort of holding their hand and taking them through it. We probably went to 20, 30 different customer sites and just, you know, over the back of their shoulder, watched them work through trying to set up a sensor and a gateway for the first time ever. One of our primary use cases was temperature sensors in freezers. So what you learn by going to a customer site versus being at your desk is, it's really, really cold inside a freezer. So things like the time it takes you to set up a device, to install that piece of equipment, it really matters. So after about 2 minutes, you can't feel your hands, you're in minus 20 degrees. Most of our effort was spent sort of getting really low fidelity, quick and dirty prototypes and just putting them in the hands of customers and saying, we know this isn't perfect, we know it's got a whole bunch of problems, but do you still think, despite that, this could sort of help you in your day-to-day work?
We were able to move incredibly fast. We were able to get our first product out to customers within 3 weeks. Within 3 months, they were using a software application. Within 6 months, we had a number of customers having bought hardware, 20 sites set up.
It's incredibly hard to bring something new into the world, but with that, it's also incredibly rewarding.
That kind of velocity is pretty unique. But at the same time, it meant that we had to perhaps delay all of the traditional product activity of putting it into a scalable application that would mean something for our customers long term. That was the cost we had to bear to have the quick wins, to have the quick learning. But if anything, that helped us grow stronger and set us up for the future really, really well.
What a product marketer owns and what a product manager owns, it is really important to be clear about that delineation.
Product marketing makes the complex simple and then the simple appealing.